After 10 years, Apple has finally updated the design of their MacBook Air with the brand new 2018 model, and from the looks of it, it's the best choice if you're trying to buy an entry-level MacBook, right? Well, not exactly. The new MacBook Air has some pretty serious shortcomings compared to last year's 13-inch MacBook Pro, which is now on sale for $100 off for a limited time on B&H, so it's the exact same price as the new MacBook Air. We think the 2017 MacBook Pro is the better choice, but of course, both laptops have their strengths, so let's take a look at what the Pro does better first. Even though the new MacBook Air finally has a Retina display with the same resolution that the Pro has, it's actually much worse. The new Air is rated at 300 nits of brightness, but Laptop Mag measured only 234. In comparison, the 2017 MacBook Pro is rated at 500 nits, and it measured in at 458 nits. That's almost twice as bright. You can see both laptops at maximum brightness, and the difference is pretty clear. Not only that, but the MacBook Pro supports P3 wide color gamut, so it's much more color accurate than the new Air. Another drawback to the new Air is the lack of performance. The Pro scored quite a bit better in Geekbench 4 CPU test, and we saw the same thing in Cinebench R15 CPU test as well. For graphics, the Pro was 50% faster in Geekbench 4, and also faster in Cinebench's graphics test. Now I know, that's why it's called the Pro, but you can buy the Pro for literally the same exact price as the Air. Also, the new MacBook Air only comes with a 30-watt power adapter, while the Pro comes with a 61-watt power adapter, so the battery on the Pro should charge almost twice as fast. The trackpad on the MacBook Pro is also significantly larger, even though the keyboards are practically the same size, so you've got more room to navigate. One thing we notice is that the speakers on the 2017 Pro are actually better than the ones on the new Air. Just listen for yourself. Based on everything we've compared so far, the MacBook Pro looks like the obvious choice. But now let's talk about some of the ways the MacBook Air is better. The Air is rated at 12 hours of battery life while the Pro only gets 10. It's also more portable, weighing in at 2.75 pounds, a quarter of a pound less than the Pro. Even though they're basically the same size if you look at them from above, the Air definitely looks thinner from the side thanks to the wedge shape. Interestingly, the Air is slightly thicker at the wide end, but much thinner near the front. The MacBook Pro's front edge tends to dig into your wrist after long typing sessions, but the Air actually slopes downward, so it's much more comfortable to type on. Not only that, but the Air has updated third generation butterfly keys that include a silicone barrier to protect the key switches from debris, which caused issues with a rare number of older gen keyboards, like on the 2017 MacBook Pro. The Air also gets Touch ID, which is really nice for logging into your account and buying things with Apple Pay. The Pro doesn't get that. The Air also comes with Apple's new T2 chip, which enables Hey Siri support and takes care of a lot of tasks like automatic file encryption, which will help it stay future-proof for years to come. However, there's been a lot of backlash over it, with many people complaining that the T2 chip blocks third-party shops from doing repairs on it, but to me, it's not a big deal at all. So which one should you buy? Well, if you care about performance, especially graphics performance, then definitely buy the Pro. And if you use your MacBook outside or constantly set your brightness to the max, then buy the Pro. If you're big on portability, honestly, there's not much of a difference. They'll both still fit in the same carrying case and you won't really notice a difference in weight. If you absolutely must get the best battery life, then the Air is the obvious choice. And if you do tons of typing every day, then the Air will be more comfortable. But I own a MacBook Pro and the Edge really doesn't bother me. And I do love the larger trackpad on the Pro as well. Another plus for the Air is that the keyboard will be more reliable thanks to the silicone barrier. And if you love having loud and clear speakers, the Pro wins there. Touch ID is nice, but I honestly don't think it'll be a big enough deal to affect someone's decision. The T2 chip is nice, but I don't think it's a big deal either, and I basically never use the Hey Siri function on my 2018 MacBook Pro. So if you're still having a hard time deciding which model to buy, tally up all of the things I mentioned and whether they're important to you or not, and then just buy the one that gets the most points. We've got links to both in the video description, including the link to the $100 off MacBook Pro sale, but it's only for a limited time, so make your decision quick. So thanks for watching, guys, and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on more videos like this one.